In our last 2 weeks in Spain, we visit beautiful beaches, vibrant towns and hilltop castles. What an adventure we are on. In search of some hiking and biking, we drive high into the mountains to discover Castella de la Frontera, a castle town perched atop a rugged mountain. The drive up is quite spectacular, and we discover a town with narrow streets and whitewashed walls inside the castle walls. Further into the mountains, we walk in the most stunning karst landscape and visit the Moorish fort at Altaquera, which was subsequently conquered and became a Christian castle. Towards the end of our trip, we discover the wild landscape of Cabo de Gata, with its wonderful beaches and coves and its spaghetti western inland towns. At the end of our visit, we spend a few days on the beach before driving back via the south of France and over the massive Central in some very surprising weather. November. Happy birthday, Johnny.
Oh yeah, Johnny's birthday today. We're in Tarifa.
Yeah, in the beautiful sunshine again. It's not mega hot, but it's warm enough that I'll probably be taking this hoodie off soon.
So we're walking down the seafront at Tarifa, heading for a coffee stop and breakfast at the cafe we found yesterday. I have been here once before when I was 10 years old with my parents. I don't remember it, but we did do a ferry trip from here to Tangiers in Morocco for the day, which I do remember, because it was quite an assault on the senses for a 10-year-old, especially when they took us around the meat market in Tangiers.
Not one for Laura.
Not one for Laura. Not one for any veggie or vegan. But I'd forgotten quite how close the continent of Africa is to Tarifa. I'll show you later when we get down into Tarifa Old Town. We'll take a look across the Straits of Gibraltar, but there's not many mornings you get to sit and have your breakfast and your breakfast coffee looking at Africa.
No, that's true.
So we're quite fortunate to be able to enjoy that today.
Tarifa Old Town is stunning, lots of beautiful little shops, and we found an artisan chocolate shop yesterday. We did sample the chocolates and decided they were so good that we have to come back today to buy some to take home for Christmas presents for people. It really was gorgeous chocolate.
Some of the best chocolate I've ever eaten. Yeah, it's really good.
So our mission today is to sit in a cafe looking over to Africa, have some breakfast, lunch, brunch, whatever you call this time of day, and then go do some shopping.
So you know you're getting near this amazing chocolate shop. The reason you know you're getting near this chocolate shop is you can smell it from down the street. And here's why you can smell it.
That's the one we have, that's really nice.
Yeah. So we're going to be sampling some more of these today and taking some home for Christmas presents as well. Aren't we, Caroline?
We are.
Let's go in.
Oh, look at the pistachio.
And buy some.
Oh, they've changed the display here, haven't they now?
More gorgeous stuff.
Do we know what we want before we go in?
Yeah, all of it.
So, how many of these squares do you want?
Eight.
Eight.
Okay, nothing else?
Yeah, so somewhere eight of those. A slice of this.
Caroline's ordering. I could literally eat everything in here.
I know.
It's so amazing.
It smells so good.
It's okay?
It's good. Good.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, yeah,
you see. Not cooked in the fridge, okay?
Okay. Not in the fridge, no. In there.
Now?
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Gracias.
Gracias.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Adios. She just told me not to put these in the fridge. I said, don't worry, they're going in my tummy. Well, I managed to find some mountain biking trails today. A great ride. Not every day you do some riding with views of the Rock of Gibraltar in the background. And in the distance, I can see, can't see out in the video, is Africa. I've got some company on the track now. Some toros. Wow. I hope it's a she. I hope it's not a bull. You behave yourself. Both of you. Oh my God, they've got me each side. Oh, blindly. You just behave yourself there. There's a girl. Thank heavens for that. Behave yourself. Don't want to get impaled up here. Nobody will find me. This is the karst scenery of El Torco. Amazing limestone formations when they're down by water over the eons. we're exploring the delightful little streets of Frigiliana, where Caroline came on holiday with Jilly Bowden a few years ago. Wanted to bring me back here to show me the amazing Angelino's chocolate coffee shop. He's moved to Malaga, so we're going to go to Malaga and find him there.
Yeah, he was worth it.
Yeah. These are stunning little streets, beautiful cobbled streets, just look so pretty. Which way, Caroline?
Cheers.
So, no snow here, Laura and Johnny. Just a beautiful view over a little Andalusian hill town to the Mediterranean. Sunday lunch on the terrace. Anyway, these overnight oats are going to keep me going on an epic cycle ride tomorrow. I'm cycling up into the hills, past an ancient caldera volcano, which is very exciting to all my geology friends. I'll talk about that on the video tomorrow.
Okay, well, where are we? You've got to, first of all, you know, you've got to say whereabouts you are. Are you cycling in Outer Mongolia to see the caldera, or are you in Spain in the region called Cabo de Gata?
Cabo de Gata, we are in Sergio Leone's famous 1965 spaghetti western film set village. That's a lot to put together there. Come out for a mountain bike ride today. Found some trails in the Cabo de Gata National Park. That's lovely. My aim is to get down to the coast and the beach where we were yesterday. Probably me and the goats going down this trail now. The riding's not easy through sand and shingle and gravel, but the rock formations are impressive. This is part of an old caldera volcano up over the top here. So this trail that I'm on has come through the mountains on a gravel track, popped out this tiny little village up on the hillside. There's not a soul around, it's so quiet. This place is very cute and picturesque. Well, I made it down to the sea, down to this little fort after being chased by a dog. It wasn't much fun. Here I am by the sea. I'm going to head over to that little white village on the coast over there for some lunch, and then we're going to drop down to this little fishing village down here. Hopefully there'll be a cafe open, a coffee con lache.
It's no one's fault, we both fell.
So we're going to go back to the van now, and I'm going to stop here for the night. What are you saying?
The trouble I've got with you.
You're no trouble with me. Nothing but good me.
Endless trouble that's I've got with you.
What's your interrogation technique?
So what are you doing?
Right, I said, don't laugh. I've set the alarm for 8 o'clock tomorrow to get up for sunrise. Don't laugh. To take some beautiful drone shots of sunrise over the village that we're staying
at. Okay, how long have we been away?
2 months.
How many times have you been up at sunrise?
Somewhere between naught and one times.
I think that's probably somewhere between naught and naught. And letting everyone know, you did get up for the golden hour. You got up.
I did.
And you did a video, didn't you, with your drone?
I did get up for sunrise. 8 o'clock alarm. 8 o'clock alarm.
Thankfully here the sunrise is late. You know, it's not 5 a.m. or anything. Don't get too excited.
Oh, yeah.
Butter wouldn't melt in his mouth. Just look at him. Everybody thinks he's the quiet one. Oh, how wrong they are. This is just getting worse and worse.
Yesterday morning on the beach sunbathing.
Yeah, on the beach sunbathing in Spain, now in the snow in France.